If you want to be able to do the handstand at least like this and hold it as long as possible, then this video is for you. Today, I'm going to share with you the most important progression, which you most likely neglect if you're watching this video. What's up guys, it's Adam from GymnasticsMethod.com. If you don't want to miss my upcoming videos, make sure to subscribe and click on the bell. And if you want to get access to all the Gymnastics Method workout programs, tutorials like planche, handstand or muscle up, nutrition guide, daily workouts and much more, click the link below and get started today. I've heard and seen so many people who wanted to learn the handstand saying that they tried so many progressions, exercises and techniques to do it right, but even with all these, they failed. The form was not right, they stepped away all the time, and if you could accidentally hold it for longer, it was totally random and not even the nicest. Now, even if the handstand looks easy from someone who can already do it, it doesn't mean it's easy. It's actually a pretty complex process, which I break down to 5 steps in my system. Joint preparation, fixing the shoulder angle if needed, creating the proper line, progressions, and developing the balance. I won't explain these here because I've already done that in one of my previous videos. If you haven't watched that already, take a look after this one. Now, I just wanted to draw your attention, if you're looking to start practicing the handstand for the first time, you better start working on these step by step instead of doing the progression I'm going to show you. Especially focusing on the joint preparation part, for which you can find a complete series on the channel. That is the most important phase if you want to prevent wrist pain, shoulder pain that many people suffer from thanks to the handstand practice, or you just simply want to make sure that your form will be correct. But now, from all those steps I've mentioned, I'd like to highlight one, actually the most important one from the progressions, which is the handstand facing the wall. Yes, you have to hold the handstand facing the wall and not against the wall. If you don't understand why I emphasize this, I've made a video about this topic where I explain my comments, so check that out too if you haven't already. Just to be clear, I don't say or assume that you will skip this progression, I'm pretty sure that you have done this before. But you've most likely done it not long enough or without the right form. As I've mentioned already, the right form mostly depends on the preparation exercises and the steps I showed you earlier. But let's say you have never done those, but you spend the right time on this progression, it would even make your handstand hold easier in itself. However, I always say, if you do something and spend time on it, why wouldn't you do it the best way and enjoy maximal results? That's why I suggest you to check out the prerequisites before you start to practice. Alright, but let's say you have all the prerequisites and you are able to do the right form facing the wall. Even in this case, you should build up the holding time to at least 60 seconds. This is what I always tell my students as a standard. Now, what's sure is that even if you're able to do the right form in this progression in the beginning, you won't be able to hold it for a minute. Many people hold it until it's comfortable, then they come down. Unfortunately, this is not enough. Think about the push-ups, for example. I'm sure sometimes you do more push-ups than what's comfortable. Okay, since that's actually a movement, it's some way easier to push through. In the handstand, you don't have to move, and it's a different, bigger load to your nervous system. But let's think about the hollow body hold or the plank as similar examples. None of these are comfortable positions, but if you want to develop a decent core strength and six-pack, you hold it longer than it's comfortable. In this handstand progression, you need to do the same in order to get a decent freestanding handstand hold. It won't be comfortable. Your blood will circulate to your head, you will feel your shoulders and upper traps burning, but believe me, it's worth the effort. You need to build up the endurance in this, so when you practice the balancing, you won't have any issue to hold it right. This is 100% my and my students' experience. Let me tell you my story. I remember the moment years ago when I realized that my handstand is not the best and I can't hold it for long, but when I can, it's absolutely random. I did gymnastics in high school and I couldn't even hold the handstand anytime I want. That's embarrassing. I didn't feel my handstand position super stable, I couldn't maintain the form and tone for long for the freestanding handstand. So I decided to go back to the wall and hold it up to 60 seconds. I could do the right form, no doubt, but I could only maintain it for like 10 seconds in the beginning. After that I felt my shoulders depressing, my core releasing, I was dizzy, etc. Like I said, same as a total beginner in the plank who wants to hold it for 2 minutes but physically incapable and giving up after 20 seconds. Time goes in a different way in these positions, I'm telling you. So I worked on this, built up the holding time gradually, and even during this process I felt my progress. it was more and more easy to hold and maintain the right form. After I achieved the 60 seconds, it was much easier to hold the freestanding handstand. Yes, that's right, but it really matters how you practice it, so let's see the key points. Shoulder width support with forward-looking fingers, locked elbows, elevated scapulas, and open shoulders. Look to the ground between your hands without bending your head backward. Tight core, posterior pelvic tilt with tight glutes, tight and closed legs with pointed feet. These are all really important points with bold, underlined and red fonts, but what's more important is that you can only support on the wall with your toes. Your belly, thighs or nothing else can touch the wall. Think about it as a long push-up position hold. There are only two contact points, your hands on the ground and your toes on the wall. That's it. You're supporting both your hands on the ground as close as possible without touching the wall with your trunk, only your toes. This is how you need to hold it for 60 seconds with paying attention to all the previous key points the whole time.
Okay.
How to start and progress? There are several ways. First of all, if you're a beginner or you have never done any of those, start with the 5 steps I mentioned earlier in the video, including the joint preparation, etc., so you can build up everything to be actually able to do this progression. If that's done, then you can start by a conservative approach and do 5-second holds in your practice. If you do this 3 times a week, always adding 5 more seconds to your hold durations, you can reach the 60 seconds in a month. This is a simple example. You can also test yourself the first time and see how long you can hold it. Let's say you can do 10 seconds. From here, you can apply the same methods I just told you or increase the time with 10 seconds weekly. As for the sets, the less seconds you hold in a set, the more sets you can do, and the more seconds you hold in a set, the less sets you can do. For example, if you do only a 5-second hold, you can do even 10 sets of it. But when you hold it for 30 seconds, it's fine to do only 3 to 4 sets. You can have 30 seconds to 2 minutes rest time between the sets, depending on how long you hold it. It's really important to monitor your practice, so the best if you can record yourself and check your form every time, at least in the beginning, until you build up the body awareness. If you haven't watched the previous videos I've mentioned, I highly recommend to do that. And if you want to follow along the whole process that I prefer in a complete system, then click the link below and get started today. It's not just a program, but an all-in-one platform where you can get support from me personally anytime in our private community. I even host live Q&As weekly where we have really good conversations with the members with valuable info, so if you want to be a part of that, get started today. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did so, please like, share, and write a comment. What do you want to see in the next videos? If you don't want to miss the new videos, subscribe with notifications on, and see you next week in the next video.